Hi, I'm Yuri Wong. I'm a media composer and I compose for film, TV, animation, radio, all sorts of media. In this video, I'm going to compare four orchestral libraries ranging from free to $49 to $449 and ultimately to $1,699. All these libraries are purchased, they are not sponsored. I use them in my productions. I really like Spitfire libraries because they sound great and they're very well designed. In this comparison, I'm going to be recreating Brian Tyler's Now You See Me cue. The way I'm approaching the arrangement is with the philosophy of if it sounds right, it is right. So I'm not going to stick to the strict orchestral arrangements of 4 to 5 parts per section and making sure I stack them in the orchestral way. I'm just going to make them sound right, and if it sounds right to me, it is right. So the bass version is the stock Logic version, which is what I arranged to get the sound and texture that I want. And after which, all the other library versions are based on the Logic version. I substituted the sounds to get the similar sound that I have in Logic. So if it's a violin spiccato, I would substitute with a violin spiccato and make sure the levels are just about the same. For the libraries that have mic placements like Albion and Symphonic Orchestra, I used the default mic settings. I didn't change them. For the BBC one, I did add a little bit more room sound to get an additional reverb in. And for the Logic version, I used Space Designer. The drums, the synths, and the percussion are identical for all four projects. They are stock Logic sounds and they're consistent throughout all four. For the tuned percussion, like the harp and marimba, all the Spitfire versions are using the BBC Discover version, and for Logic, it's just stock Logic. Alright, let's check it out. I think it's more fun not knowing which library is which, so let's go into this blind. Each color represents a library. We have A, B, C, and D. A small section of the cue is going to be played, followed immediately by the same section again from a different library. So have a listen for the characteristics of each library and how they sound. Here we go. So after listening, what do you think? Tell me your thoughts in the comments. Now for the big reveal. Which library is which? For BBC Discover, you can hear that it's recorded in a different space from Albion 1 and Symphony Orchestra. It's got this spaciousness about it. even with the setting set to dry, the sound that you have for Discover is this pretty wet ambient sound. And you can tell that the horns are kind of weak as well. So that's the thing, you get a bit more of a limited palette with BBC because of the lower price as well. The range of articulations are not exactly there in the BBC Discover, and that's understandable for a $49 or free library. For Albion 1, the strings are very lush, and it's probably the largest section, string section of all the libraries over here. I feel like Spitfire Albion is more of a string-centric library because I feel like the brass has a bit of a feeling of being an afterthought in this library. So when it comes to symphony orchestra, I think you have the most flexible options because there are so many articulations and so many possibilities that you can shape your sound. But when it comes to brass, Spitfire Symphony Brass really has that classy sound and all the kinds of articulations that you would want in a brass library. The higher up in price you go, the more articulations and options you have in the library, like mic placement and control over the articulations, which mean you can be more subtle in your arrangement and you can have more variety in the way the orchestra plays. I feel like generally whatever works is whatever sounds right and creates the right emotion. Ultimately, what matters is the music you create from the tools that you have. And music, to me, is an emotional vehicle, a way to convey a set of emotions to an audience very quickly. Too often, we focus our attention and our money on upgrading the sounds that we have and the tools to be fancier, when we should be looking at upgrading our skills and knowledge and our practice to be able to better create the music that we want to. Naturally, it feels safer to explore sound libraries or synthesizers or plugins rather than exploring our responsibility to creating the emotional connection with our music. The truth of the matter is, I don't need all these libraries. Ultimately, I consider the success of whether something was good or not was that whether the audience reacted emotionally to the music in a good way. In my opinion, when we move away from thinking about tools towards thinking about the skills to craft emotional journeys for people, then our own musical journey will be much more fulfilling. I hope you found this video useful. I wish you all the best in your musical creations. Happy making music! Thank you.
Thank you.